Kevin, what are you doing?
Oh, I gotta put a couple more bends in this piece. Piece of 1-inch solid rod. It's the tree bark pattern that I use to make some of my vine sculptures out of. And I want to get a couple more bends in. Well, for that I'm going to need the oxygen acetylene torch, because I just can't bend it by hand. So we'll heat it up in a couple of places. You want to watch?
You bet.
Cool. Come on over here. See, we got a... This is a great little vise. Not only does the head swivel in all different directions, but it's got this great little pipe jaw inside this thing. So I can put my piece down in there. And as soon as you tighten the jaw up, it doesn't swivel anymore. Got to fix that on the workbench. So now we just need our dark glasses, oxygen acetylene torch, this tip. See this? This is called a rosebud tip, or a heating tip. They come in several different sizes. And if you look at those, see them?
Yep.
Okay. This one is a number 4. This one is a number 8. And the only difference between the two is one has 2 more holes than the other. So you just get a little more flame out of it. This one heats up a lot quicker, a lot bigger area than this one will. But this one uses gas a lot faster than this one will. So we'll use this one today. So, where'd they go? There they are. My mechanical fingers here. You see, when I start to heat something, especially thick like this, I'll go ahead and stay right in one spot until it starts to get red. Some people like to work all around, they like to work up and down, you know. I just think it heats up a little quicker if I just hold it right there and let it get red hot, and then I can move around. It looks more orange right now than it does red. But once it gets up to a nice bright red for me, with the glasses on, then I think it's about ready to bend. And it doesn't take a whole lot of pressure. I mean, you know, anybody can do it, as long as you get it hot enough. See, once you start your bend, now you start moving up on around the heat. Move up where you've got it red hot. Move up just a little bit to where it's a little bit colder. And get that hot. Let the other end start to cool. And you can control your bend a little better to get a nice smooth bend in it rather than all herky-jerky. And yes, that's a technical word.
Burn it if you leave the flame on there too much?
Oh yeah, if you get too close to it, or you hold your flame in one place too long, which you'll actually start to burn the carbon right out of the steel, and you'll actually turn it more back into iron, like the iron ore, rather than steel, which has the carbon mixed into it. And that makes it brittle. So it kind of ruins the pattern, makes it look a little different. Not a good thing. But now my wrench is starting to get hot, so I'll go ahead and get that out of the way. until I get it hot again. Then I can go back in and grab it and just get a little more bend on it. If I was going to be doing this a lot, you know, several pieces or a big long piece, I'd have a bucket of water where I could just drop my wrench down into it, let the wrench cool off.
Do you ever cool the piece itself that you're heating up?
I'm sorry?
Do you ever cool the piece that you're heating up itself?
Well, that's another way to control the bending. You take like a squirt bottle, and I can come back over on the back side of my bead over there and squirt it with a squirt bottle. Cool that area down and get it hot enough somewhere else. Control my bend that way too. This is just a scale from when they manufactured it in the foundry, and I'm just burning the scale off. So it's just getting a little bit hotter. Get the torch out of the way. Now I can come back over here and grab it with both hands. You don't want to grab it right now. And that's just bending with the oxygen acetylene torch. Different size tips. All kinds of cool stuff. Hang on a minute. So just to show you how hot it is, this is an infrared thermometer. And it won't even read on the 3-digit gauge. So it's up over 1,000 degrees. Yeah, that'll leave a mark. Well, I'm gonna go get this cold now in the sink so I can go back to work. So I'll see y'all next time.